a young guy who eats badly, sleeps badly, smokes, drinks too much alcohol, misses half of his gym workouts, and takes steroids can blow away the most dedicated, most gifted athlete who does not take steroids in terms of sheer muscle gain.
It does take athletes to the next level. If you are swinging a bat, you can use a heavier bat, or you can swing it faster. If you're running, sprinting, you can run faster. That's why you find so many athletes using them.
No, motherfuckers, because they work their ass off and because they have great genetics. I've been friends of mine that I know for a fact are not taking steroids, that have a physique that I can honestly say is as good, if not better, than mine. I've been taking steroids for 25 years. I am not so insecure and fucked up that I can't admit that somebody has a better body than me and does not take steroids.
But this could be a young man who dominates the next 10 years of rugby league. Is that good?
Sports supplements claim to offer improved performance.
Tend to make you stronger, recover quicker.
But can you be sure of what you're getting?
It is not doing what it says on the tub.
Sportsmen have failed drugs tests because of them.
You know, it was just the end of the world for me.
But do sports supplements work?
With most of these supplements, there's no research to support it.
To me, genetics is everything, and keeping your genetics the way they're supposed to be, not ruining them with drugs.
Sam says he had the ability, but he didn't have the size to compete, so he ended up taking a shortcut to get there. That's a familiar story to Nicole Sapstead. She's in charge of catching dopers in UK sport.
Our intelligence is telling us that there is a doping issue at the lower levels of rugby union.
Big. You know, big. I'm 280, I'm 280 pounds. Take your shirt off. Yeah, you look like a fat motherfucker. You look like shit. You
know? In this game, being bigger can mean getting further. But more players than ever are being caught using steroids to get there. Of all the UK sportsmen currently serving bans for taking an illegal substance, almost 60% are rugby players.
Perfect specimen for rugby union. Explosive, big.
On the pitch, they want to hurt you. But after the game, they want to have a beer or two, spending time with you as a player.
The side effects of anabolic steroids can be serious. They include liver damage, high blood pressure, acne, and heart problems. Tom says he once tried a pro hormone without realising what it was.
I had a lot of bad side effects off them, with like bad kidneys, I had a spotty back, and I got a bit aggressive, which I didn't like, so I stopped taking them. Yeah, I've had a couple of friends who've taken them. They've had like bad experience with them. They've had like, you know, gyno, which is like man boobs growing. It's not a nice experience, to be honest.
But don't look for an easy way out. Nobody wants to work hard these days. Everybody wants the easy way, the 20-minute abs, the 10-minute this, 10-minute that. Fuck that. Come to the gym, work your ass off.
Offloads, line breaks, and basically the end of it feeling like you've been in a car crash.